Can you Surrey? Can you picnic? Whoa.
Ahead, remembering the unforgettable voice of Laura Nyro.
Come on, come on, and Surrey down.
It is a bittersweet truth of our electronic age that a singer can occasionally win over new fans long after he or she is gone. Our friend Bill Flanagan of VH1 says something like that may be happening now to a singer of the past that many people have all but forgotten.
Let's talk for a minute about Laura Nyro. There was a moment in the late 1960s when Laura Nyro was one of the most important figures in pop music. She was a wildly talented girl from New York City who sat at the piano and let songs pour out of her. She was both a white soul sister and the female Bob Dylan. Laura seemed to embody the pure spirit of music. In 1967, she signed a multi-million-dollar deal with Columbia Records, and the songs she wrote started becoming big hits for other singers.
I'm not scared of dying, and I don't really care.
Blood, Sweat, and Tears sang Laura's And When I Die. Barbara Streisand did Stony End.
Era's coming.
Three Dog Night had a number one with Eli's Coming.
I love you so, always will.
Fifth Dimension had big hits with Stone Soul Picnic and Wedding Bell Blues. Everybody had hits with Laura Nyro songs except Laura Nyro, but Laura made beautiful albums on which she opened her soul and let everything out. Laura had a hard time with the expectations of the marketplace.
Yeah.
In the summer of 1967, she played the Monterey Pop Festival. This was the same show where Janis Joplin and Jimi Hendrix and The Who became big stars.
It looks good and dirty on shiny light strip. And if you don't get beat, you got yourself a trip. You can.
Laura came out in front of the hippie audience dressed in a black gown with a soul band. I think she wanted to be like Aretha Franklin or one of the Motown acts, but the hippies thought she looked like something out of Vegas, and they booed her off the stage. Well, at least that's the story that got repeated for 30 years. Apparently, Laura believed it, too. It's always written that Monterey shattered her confidence. The thing is, it wasn't true. The audience at Monterey didn't hate her at all. When she died, I went to see D.A. Pennybaker, who filmed the festival. And Mr. Pennybaker showed me the footage of Laura's performance. It had never been seen.
Wow.
But from what we could tell, most of the audience liked her. People were clapping and cheering. You know, maybe a few jerks booed or yelled insults, but it was blown all out of proportion by the people who wrote about it later and by Laura. Laura Nyro retired from the music business in the early 70s. She moved up to New England, she had a child, and she raised him away from the spotlight. Once in a while, though, she'd come back and work. She recorded and toured a couple of times in the mid-70s, very low-key, very homemade.
I wrote this next song for my kid. What is life? Did you read about?
She vanished again for over a decade. She came back in the early 90s, made two albums, and started playing in some nightclubs.
Innocence, my innocence comes from my mother earth. Innocence, my innocence comes from my one earth mother.
And then, in 1997, she died. Ovarian cancer, a very sad ending to a very unusual life. But the spirit she sent out keeps touching down in unusual places. There's an off-Broadway musical called Eli's Coming, which is made up of Laura's songs.
Eli.
On stage, four women take the audience on the same journey Laura's music took.
Can you celebrate? Can you picnic?
From wide-eyed romantic innocence through heartbreak, obsession, and finally a kind of serene wisdom. I sure never expected to hear any new Laura Nyro music, though, so I was very surprised when this new CD showed up recently. It turns out that the whole time she was battling cancer, Laura was writing and recording new songs.
Angel of my heart.
They're beautiful.
Come back to me.
I guess when she found out she had cancer, Laura poured everything she had into making a last great musical statement. And she really pulled it off.
'Cause I can't live no more without an angel.
But after she died, it took her friends 4 years to find a record company that wanted to put it out. That's hard to get a handle on. A great recording artist summoned the talent and courage to make music this beautiful in the face of death. And when she did, it took years to find a label to release it. But anyway, it's here now, living proof. There was no one else like Laura Nyro.
And when I die,
ahead, the inside scoop on the ice cream sundae.